Morning again. So I'll start with what is tangible versus what is intangible. So as you must be aware, tangible is something which you can measure: assets, companies, warehouses, people, cars, office vehicles, everything which you can measure. Versus intangible is something which you can't measure, but it is still valuable. So I just couple of months back I went through a video which was telling me that Microsoft is a company which is having $3 billion worth of assets as tangible assets, versus they are having $300 billion assets which are intangible assets. So what we have seen in the past maybe 10, 12 years is most of the companies are now putting a lot of money on intangible assets, because intangible assets you can, you know, take anywhere. So I'll just take you through the next slide, Vijay. So how to value content as an asset? So when we actually do content writing, it is an asset because you build on content. Now suppose I get a company which is a very new company which is just having their own logo and, you know, which just started a couple of months back. We will put so much of content, you know, by researching and, you know, things like that. By another 4 months or 5 months, they have so much of content on their social media sites which they can refer, you know, their clients can see, their employees can see. So this is the value of content. So this is my company, Blue Skies. So we develop social media strategies and we are into the storytelling business. So what we do ideally is, so we tell your story in bits and pieces. So normally, if you give somebody a very big brochure to read, hardly very few people will read it. They will only read the headlines and they will keep it aside. Social media is something where, you know, we tell your story, your brand story in bits and pieces, the way you work, what are your values and things like that. So we ideally, essentially, we are into the storytelling business. So this is the, you know, normally nowadays anything you buy, if it is maybe something like a mobile for 20,000 rupees or a Honda City car for say 10 lakh rupees, normally when people buy something, they are on social media for that particular product for a couple of weeks or a couple of months or maybe a year. So they will actually see what is happening on social media. What are the new features of the car? What are the new colors available? What is something which they don't know? So normally when people buy something, ideally they are on social media for couple of months depending on the value of the product. These are the some benefits, you know, brand awareness, brand loyalty helps conversions and also deals with the issue of perceived indifference, which I covered in my last presentation. Next, please. So why us? So we strategize. What we do is we will study your brand. So when I say you, I am not selling to the room, it is only for ease of communication. We will study your brand, we will study your competitors, we will study what is happening in the industry, and accordingly we will start, you know, we will do a strategy. Strategy could be, you know, only brand awareness. After a couple of months it could be lead generation, it could be answering somebody's questions, you know, your customers' questions through social media. So this is the strategy. We of course do content writing by studying everything about you, your competitors. After some time, you know, when we exhaust everything, we will start studying so much that, you know, most of the times I have heard reviews from people that, you know, they have not studied so much about themselves, because we are having a marketing angle. I'm not saying that, you know, we will actually go deep into the technicalities. From the marketing angle, we study so much. Of course, then afterwards we create visuals, because humans store visuals in their brain. Humans don't store data. Humans don't store numbers. So we will create visuals. So one is the content and one is the form. So then we create the form. This form is then, you know, of course, posted on regularly, consistently on social media platforms like you know, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn. If yours is a visual brand, Instagram, Facebook are very important for you, because actually people will see. Even if it is not a visual brand, like we are doing work for Richwick now, I think for more than 6 years. His brand is not a visual brand, it is all technicalities. Still, we convert those into visuals, you know, with some lines and visuals. So that is our specialty. Next, please. And afterwards, once you have enough data on your social media platform, you know, that is the time. So you have enough branding now done. So we will actually help you create, you know, generate some leads. Of course, we'll take money from you for that. This is a case study. I'll just quickly run through. So this is a fashion brand. It is essentially a B2C brand. So this is the kind of visuals we make. there is something on the visual, there is a headline, there is a body copy, and you know, people read. The benefit they got is they got exposure in a couple of cities like Delhi, Chandigarh. They also exhibited in Dubai. So, next please. So this is a hospital where actually we are not selling directly. So you know, there is a brand awareness. We are talking about various ways of preventing disease. So we are not even talking about diseases. But never we say that you come to this hospital. Basically, it is to promote the hospital through indirect, giving gyan about the diseases and other things. And third is, this is a complete B2B where you know the audience is actually literate. The audience knows what are the terms. So we will take it a step further. In the previous two things, we will use the layman's language where you know the people will understand because the people are laymen. Here we use literate technical language where you know people are already graduates and you know they are into HR, things like that. So you know these are a couple of examples. And this is how we add value. So now we have art and innovation. They are into home decor, so we could give them 300 plus leads. Reach week, you know, we could give them around 41 leads in last 6 months. TAC hospital, we could reach 10,000 plus people. And you know, now we are doing for work for one fitness adda where we could reach around 60,000 people only on Ghodbandar Road. Aritra Food Works, they are into food franchising business, so we could give them 350 leads. Waterfield, they are into rainwater harvesting, we could give them around 43 leads. And Shakti equipment, they are into rentals of aerial work platforms and telehandlers. Again, this month only we could give them 147 leads. These are a couple of my leads. I will send you my PPT. So if you want connection with any of these companies, you can ask me. So I am looking to get connected to resort owners, apparel manufacturers, and fast moving consumer good manufacturers. You know, which they require social, anybody and everybody actually needs social media, even if it is a completely technical brand. Like Shakti Equipments is a completely technical, you know, they are only selling kind of cranes and, but you know, still the kind of awareness what most of the time when they call people, people say, well, we didn't even know that something like this exists, you know. So it is very much essential for each and every company, even if it is a B2C, B2B, NGO, anybody. Next please. So remember, your phone and your fingers are together all the time, and that's where your customers are. Thank you.